Hello students,
now we are going to proceed. Function filters is linear equation in two variables. Now in this part, that is the part number 4, we will discuss the method of solving the linear equation in two variables. When we have the linear equation in two variables, then how we will solve and how can we get the value of x and y. So we are going to solve or we are going to see the methods. There are three methods for solving the linear equation when the linear equation is present in the two variable. There are three methods. First method is substitution. Second is elimination. And third is cross multiplication. Third is cross multiplication. There are three methods for solving the linear equation when the linear equation is present in the two variables. Then how and by these three methods we can get the value of x and y. Okay. Now one by one we will see all of the three methods. First is the substitution method. When first is, this is the general equation of linear equation, a1x plus b1y equal to c1. This is the first general linear equation. And if the two variables are present, then you have two equations. Then you can get the value of x and y. If you have two variables, then you have to get two equations. If you have three variables, then you have to get the three equations for solving. Minimum three equations can solve the three variables. Here is the two variables. So you have to get two equations for solving or getting the value of x and y. So second is a2x plus b2y equal to c. This is the first general linear equation. Second is general linear equation. Now solve it by the method of substitution. Substitution. We are going to see the first method, substitution method. In substitution method, you have to get the value of one variable in terms of second variable and put that value into another linear equation. Like this is the first linear equation, a1x plus b1y equal to c1. Then you have to get the value of x or y in terms of another variable. You want to get the value of x, then you can get the value of x in terms of y from this equation. You can get second equation, you can take first equation, either you can take one of the two equations for getting the value of one variable in terms of another variable. Now we can take the value of x from here in terms of y. a1x will be equal to c1 minus b1y. Now for getting the value of x, the multiple of x will be goes to divide x equal to c1 minus b1y upon a1. This is the value of x from the first general linear equation. Then put this value of x in second general linear equation. Second general linear equation is a2x plus b2y equal to c2. Then put this value of x in second equation. Then the equation will be in terms of y, a2 into c1 minus b1y upon a1 plus b2y equal to c2. Here a2 is constant, c1 is constant, a1 is constant, b1 is constant, b2 is constant and c2 is constant. There is a one thing which is variable in whole of the equation, that is the y. Whole equation is in terms of y. Then you can get the value of y from here. What is the value of y? This will be a2 c1 upon a1 minus a2 b1 y upon a1 plus b2 y equal to c2. this is constant, complete term is constant, so it will go is to right hand side plus b2. Now from here take LCM from both. Now minus a2 b1 by plus a1 b2 by whole upon a1 equal to c2 minus a2 c1 upon a1. This will go on to right RHS or right hand side. Now from here you can take the common by remaining will be minus a2 b1 plus a1 b2 whole upon a1 c2 a1, take LCM, minus a2 c1 upon a1. Now this is the multiple of y, so it will go is into divisible. Now you can get the value of y, that is y equal to a1 c2 minus a2 c1, a1 c2 minus a2 c1 whole upon a1. Now a1 is in divisible, so it will go into multiply a1 whole upon this complete term, that is minus a2 b1 plus a1 b2 is in multiple of by, so it will go into divide minus a2 b1 plus a1 b2. A1 is cancel, value of y is a1 c2 minus a2 c1 whole upon a1 b2 minus a2 b1. This is the value of y. This is the complete value of y. And put this value in either of the equation, either of the first equation, either of the second equation. And when you put the value of y, then the complete equation will be in terms of x. Then you can get the value of x. Okay? Now, note it. This is in general form. Now we'll take an example and solve the value of x and y. Pause the video and note it down. Now we are going to see an example of two linear equations that how to solve with the substitution method. These are two equations, 5x plus 4y equal to 3, and second linear equation is 7x plus 3y equal to 9. Then you have to solve and get the value of x and y by the substitution method. Then for the substitution method, you have to take one of the linear equation and get the value of one variable in terms of another variable. We are going to take the first linear equation, then 5x plus 4y equal to 3. This is the first linear equation, and from the first linear equation you have to get the value of x or y in terms of other x and y. If you are going to take the value of x in terms of y, and if you are going to take the value of y, then that will be in terms of x. Now we are going to calculate the value of x. 5x equal to 3 minus 4y, and the multiple of x is 5, then it will go into divide x equal to 3 minus 4y upon 5. This is the value of x, and put this value of x in another equation, and two equations are given, and from the first equation we calculate the value of x, that is 3 minus 4y upon 5, and this, and you put this value of x in second linear equation. See, second linear equation is 7x plus 3y equal to 9. Put this value into this. X value is 3 minus 4y upon 5 plus 3y equal to 9. Solve it. 7 3s are 21 upon 5 minus 7 4s are 28 upon 5 plus 3y equal to null. Take constant on RHS, then here will be minus 28 upon 5 by plus 3 by equal to 9 minus 21 upon 5. Now take LCM on LHS as well as on RHS. Here will be LCM 5 minus 28 by plus 5 3 is 15 by equal to. And when you are going to take LCM on RHS, then it will be on 5, 9 5 is 45 minus 21. Cancel out. Here will be minus 28 by plus 15 by. Minus 28 plus 15 minus 13 by equal to 45 minus 21, 24. Now you get the value of y, that is y equal to minus 24 by 13. You get the value of y, that is minus 24 by 13. And put this value of y into either of the one equation, that is the first equation or second equation, then you can get the value of x. Now put the value of y in first or second, in first, when you put the value of y in first, then 5x plus 4y equal to 3, value of y is minus 24 by 13, 5x plus 4 into minus 24 by 13 equal to 3. 5x minus 24 4 ja 96 upon 13 equal to 3. 5x equal to 3 plus 96 by 13. 5x equal to 13 3 ja 39 plus 96 upon 13. Solve it. 5x equal to 9 or 6 13 1. 9, 3, 12 and 13 upon 13. X equal to 135 by 13 into 5. Cancel out. 5, 2 is 10. 5, 7 is 10. Now the value of X is 27 by 13. By the method of substitution, you get the value of X, that is 27 by 13, and value of Y is minus 24 by 13. Again, I am repeating that for the substitution method, from one of the equation you have to calculate the value of x or y in terms of other, means you are, if you are going to calculate the value of x, then it will be in terms of y. If you are going to calculate the value of y, then it will be in terms of x, means you have to calculate the value of one variable x or y into other variable x or y. Okay, now the second method is we will elaborate with the another example for the substitution method. Second example, equal to 5, 5x minus 6y equal to 10, 9. These are the two linear equation, that is the first and second. Now for the substitution, you have to get the value of one variable from either of the equation into other variable. From here you can get the value of x in terms of y, or you can get the value of y in terms of x. From here you can get the value of x in terms of y and value of y in terms of x. From the first, from first equation, that is 2x plus 3y equal to 5, you have to calculate the value of x or value of one variable in terms of another variable. We are going to calculate the value of x in terms of y, or you can get the value of y in terms of x. Now 2x equal to 5 minus 3y x value is 5 minus 3 by whole upon 2. This is the value of x from the first equation, and put this value of x in the second equation. Now, put the value of x in second. When you are going to put the value of x in second equation, then the equation will be in terms of y, and you can get the value of y. 5x minus 6y is equal to 9. This is the second linear equation. And put this value of x, 5. 5 minus 3y whole upon 2 minus 6y equal to 9. 5, 5 is 25 whole upon 2 minus 5, 3 is 15 by whole upon 2 minus 6y equal to 9. Now this is the constant, take on RHS, minus 15 by upon 2 minus 6y equal to 9 minus 25 by 2. Take minus common from LHS and take the LCM. 15 by upon 2 plus 6y. When you multiply on RHS with the negative, then it will be reciprocated. 25 upon 2 minus 9. Okay. Now take LCM on LHS as well as on RHS. Here will be 2 is the LCM. This will be 15y plus 6 to the 12y equal to, take LCM, 2, 25 minus 18. Now 2 will be cancelled out. Here will be 15 on 12 given over. 27 by equal to 25 minus 18 is 7. Now the value of y is 7 upon 27. From here you get the value of y, that is 7 upon 27. And put this value of y in either of one equation, in first equation or in second equation. When you put this value of y in first or second, then you will get the value of x. Now put the value of y in first. Put this value of y in first equation, that is 2x plus 3y equal to 5. The value of y is 2x plus 3, 3 into 7 upon 27 is equal to 5. 3 9 is 27. Take on RHS, 2x equal to 5 minus 7 by 9. 2x equal to 9, 5 is 45, 45 minus 7 is 38. 38 by 9. X is equal to 38 by 9 divided by 2. This will be cancelled out. 19. X value is 19 upon 9. You get the value of X and Y with the method of substitution. Okay? Now in the next video, we will discuss with the other method, that is the elimination method and cross multiplication method. Thank you.